What specs should you be looking for when it comes to a video editing computer? Or a computer that's just gonna help you create awesome content? In this video, I'll be sharing the top 4 specs you need to understand when it comes to selecting or upgrading your video editing computer in this edition of Value Sessions. Salutations, everybody! I'm Benjamin Brandon, and this is Value Sessions, where I focus on tech reviews and tutorials to support the quality and the budget of video creators like you. And if you are new here, what's up? And you're a video creator. This channel is all about supporting you, so I would think about subscribing. Along with talking about the 4 specs you need to understand when it comes to a video editing computer, I'm also unboxing one of the best benchmark performance machines for video editing out today, the MacBook Pro 2017 with Touch Bar. Plus, I think you might want to stick around for the last segment as I answer the question,
Can you use MacBook Pro with Touch Bar in Final Cut and iMovie?
What he said. So without further ado, let's do this. I'm gonna quickly take you on a look down memory lane, not only where we've come from, but give you real life examples of the minimum requirements you really need for a video editing computer that won't break your wallet. And for that, I'm gonna need the help of a very special guest today. Zono Ben. This is gonna be an interesting video. Let's date back to 2006, shall we? American Idol was in its first season, and it was the number one hit show in the world.
This is American Idol, let's go.
Taylor Hicks won that year.
Who?
Exactly. Britney Spears and K-Fed split.
I really missed K-Fed.
High School Musical was released and it was a phenom on the Disney Channel. Us millennial kids may remember some of that.
We're breaking free!
JT's Sexy Back was the top of the charts. Yeah. And the first model of the MacBook Pro was released, replacing the old PowerBook G4s, moving from PowerPC processors to Intel.
And this is the new MacBook Pro. It has an Intel Core Duo chip in it.
What does that mean? Stick around, we'll get there. So the 2006 MacBook Pro was actually the first computer that I've ever had to create video content with.
An oldie but a goodie.
At a 2.0 gigahertz Intel Core 2 Duo processor, it was fast for its time. Equipped with only 2 gigs of RAM, an LED backlit display, and a 160 gig hard drive. Like HDD, not SSD.
That's a very old computer.
At the time, I was able to create these videos just fine with it. However, it took a long time. What took a long time? One is rendering. Rendering is the time it takes for your computer to understand the changes that have been made on that particular clip. And essentially, it's like a very long copy and paste. The higher your processors, and the higher your GPUs, the faster render time you get. Then we have the iMac series that started shortly after.
Very good computer, however, it's heavy and not mobile.
I purchased my first 2008 iMac, which had beefier specs than the MacBook Pro. It did have a 2.4 gigahertz Intel Core 2 Duo processor, 6 gigs of RAM, and not much of a beefier graphics card, oddly enough. But it was faster because of the processor, which means rendering and exporting times were awesome.
Then there was the unibody MacBook Pro.
Very, very nice indeed, but there's better.
Now this computer is awesome, and this computer can still stand with the big boys today. But I was able to max this MacBook Pro out with 16 gigs of RAM and a 1 terabyte solid state drive, SSD. Big difference between hard drive and solid state drive. But we'll get to that in a sec. All in all, this computer made a good amount of videos on my channel today and can still serve as a very good video creator. But I had to go for a little bit more speed and a little bit more convenience. And that's why I got... The MacBook Pro with Touch Bar is equipped already with a Retina display, which already enhances the pixels I can actually see when my videos are shot. With a quad-core Intel i7 processor, I have more cores to delegate commands to. It has 16 gigs of RAM, dual Leo graphics cards, and to top it off, a blazing fast SSD.
Why did you move to a newer computer?
I got this computer because it is the creme de la creme when it comes to high performance video editing machines, but is it worth the price point?
Oh hell no!
For me, I needed more speed, I needed more convenience. That right there alone set me up. But what does all this mean? This history lesson has set you up to now understand the 4 specs we're about to get into now. Quickly note that your baseline specs will allow you to do the job. The lower the numbers, the slower you usually go though. The first spec to understand is processor, or CPU. Your CPU should be a 2.0 gigahertz dual core or higher. When it comes to a processor, consider 2 gigahertz as your baseline. Where it gets a little bit more invasive on the processor is dual core versus quad core. Quad core recommended. Just consider cores on a processor to mean more multitasking capabilities. The way I like to think about it is I'm the CEO and I have 2 to 4 assistants. The more people I have to command and delegate to, the more stuff I'll get done. Dual core is your 2 assistants who can do a lot, but quad core, 4 assistants or more. You can totally get a lot done with a lot more assistants. Kind of like Don Draper.
Dr. Miller is here to see you. It's a shame
The second thing is a solid state drive versus a hard disk drive. When it comes to storage, your baseline is an HDD. 7200 is absolutely preferred and recommended. However, you could also get away with the 5400. What's a little bit more recommended is a solid state drive. In regards to size, it's really up to you. If you're using a scratch disk, 1 or 2 terabytes is perfect. What the hell's a scratch disk? It stores all your video content and your projects and all of your rendered video. So the stress is less off of your actual computer and more on the external drive itself. Scratch disks are pretty dope and you should probably use them regardless, but let's move on. The third thing is your graphics card or GPU. Your graphics card is pretty easy to get away with, especially if you have a really good display. But your baseline for a GPU is 128 bits, and what's recommended is a 256. The higher the number, the faster you go. A 256-bit card is just enough. And the last thing is RAM.
Making the RAM 150 the obvious choice.
Not the card, dog. The memory. 8 gigs is your baseline, 16 is preferred, and 32 is amazing. Anything below 8 gigs is very hard and very slow to do. The great thing is almost all entry-level computers are equipped with 8 gigs now.
Yeah, baby.
So I hope that was helpful, and that's really all you need to know when it comes to selecting a computer for your video editing. Now we're going to unbox one of the top-of-the-line options, the MacBook Pro with Touch Bar. And now we're going to do the sexy shots. Roll them! You have import. Simply tap on the import button, which gives you the import window. Next, you're able to adjust the timeline. You can either shrink or expand. Okay, scrolling is made super simple here. Take your finger and scroll around. Time saver. So dope. You're even able to jump within the timeline. Accessing your toolbar has never been made easier. Simply tap on what you want. That's it. The ability to trim out the playhead is amazing and has saved me tons of time. Okay, this feature is my favorite. The ability to adjust volume. You're able to take the scroll bar here and adjust your decibels right here. Fast and precise. By far the best feature with the touch bar. You're also able to add fade-ins with the touch of a button. Oh, and fade-outs. Amazing. So in iMovie, you have the new movie button. Tap on it here, and there you go. The add to movie button is really cool. Simply tap on it, and it drops your clip right into the timeline. And yes, the touch bar does show love for iMovie, as you're also able to adjust your decibels in iMovie, just like you were able to in Final Cut Pro with the slider. And if that wasn't a time saver, this is another time saver here, split at playhead. Just mark your cut, and then hit the split button. And lastly, you have Add to Overlay, which brings up your picture-in-picture, green screen, and side-by-side options. Simply tap on one, and it drops right into the timeline. And that's it. Those are just some of my favorite features when it comes to the touch bar with Final Cut and iMovie. Pretty dope. And that's a wrap. So with everything that was taught, I hope it was very valuable for you. If you want to take a look at actual computers with all these baseline specs and some of the higher specs, I've gone ahead and listed a couple of examples in the description below.
Check them out.
And if this video did provide value for you and you are new here, consider subscribing, dog. And for all of you that have been here before, if it did provide value, smash that that like button for me. And if all of y'all want to receive a heads up on the next video,
I'm gonna hit that bell or something.
We'll see you on the next value session, but until then, peace!
It's a me, Zoro Ben. If you are watching this end of the video, you have been here before. This is details of the 100 subscriber giveaway, which will always appear at the end of the videos. Stay tuned. Just make sure you subscribe to the channel. Goodbye.